Hey guys, I'm here doing a review on a compound bow case. This one is called the Plano Bowguard. It has, if we look a little further down, it's got the pillar lock kit in it. It just helps with stability and so the case doesn't get crunched if you're like on airlines. You first recognize about this case is that it has some pretty big latches on it. If you can see that right there, I'll tilt it down here in a minute so you can see and get a little better picture on them. But it's got four of these latches, two on each side. What's good about these latches is that they already come with, you can see that little hole right there on that one, it already comes with a key lock already inside the latch itself, so you don't have to worry about putting an additional lock on this case, which is very nice when you're going through airlines and stuff. I'm gonna go ahead and tilt it down for you guys and open it up. Don't look at that Xbox case. That's just my device to help prop up this case for you. Seems to do a pretty good job. When you first open this case, you realize that it has got a lot of room. It's got places to put 12 arrows. These could be small arrows, thin in diameter, or large. I put six Pro Tours in there for you, which is a target arrow. It's an Easton arrow. They are very skinny for outdoor shooting, and the case supports those skinny arrows. I also put some Eclipses, X7 Eclipses, which is what the pros use for their indoor shooting. These arrows can get to be pretty thick. These are just the 27 or a 2315 size, so they're about the size of a dime, but that's still pretty thick for an arrow, and the Plano Bowguard case comes with those arrow arrow racks that can support those thick arrows as well as the skinny arrows. I'm gonna go ahead and put in a compound bow hunting setup for you guys so you can see how much space it has. I'm using a Bow Madness XS PSC. This is a 28.5 inches axle to axle bow. As you're about to find out, it's gonna fit in there pretty nicely. This is a short bow, so this case fits it pretty well. I'm gonna go ahead and strap it in for you guys so you guys can see. For the bow itself, you got three latches, or three Velcro straps. You got one on both limbs, and you also have one on the string to keep it nice and secure inside there. You also see stabilizers, short stabilizers on hunting setup bows. This is a Octane 3D Hunter, so it is the 11.5-inch stabilizer. Just going to be able to put that one in there. Fits in there nicely. This is the Octane Bantamweight Quiver, four arrows. And you're about to find out it fits in there nicely too. So there is a hunting setup. I don't have any hunting arrows with me at the moment. They're stacked over there somewhere. But you have already shown you that the case can withstand thick and skinny arrows. So anything in between here can also support. And that's pretty much it for a hunting setup. You can also have stuff like this over here. Standard release. It's a little trigger release. There's no particular place you can put this in a case that's, you know, the right place to put it there. I sometimes just strap it around the bow to keep it in there. So that's fine for your release. These are compound bow limbs, replacement limbs. These can fit in here as well if you want to move some stuff around. You can also latch those in there as well. Like if you'd like to move the stabilizers or clip them in with this strap here against the bow or something, you could do that. So everything fits in there nicely for a hunting setup bow. I'm going to go ahead and show you a target setup bow. Go ahead and take all this stuff out of here. For my target setup bow, I have a PSC Moneymaker. I don't know if you've ever heard about them before, but they are a long bow. They're about 40 inches axle to axle. As you can see here, it fits in there nicely. I mean, it's got another inch or two on each side. And the padding is going to keep it from rubbing up against the sides of or the walls of the case. You also see stabilizers in target bows today. I have a X10 setup or a series of stabilizers. That's the long 32-inch stabilizer with the side rods, your V-bolt, and your 5-inch extender. So there's a stabilizer system all set up in there, not going anywhere. You also have a sight. This is a Sherlock Supreme. This is the only thing bad about this case. It doesn't have any slots. Maybe you could put your case, separate case for your sight. The Sherlock sight actually comes with this particular plastic case. It's just a protector series, Plano, if you can see that. So you can't fit this in here anywhere. I'm sure some people get creative, but I just decided to carry it alone. If you get a soft case for the sight, you can probably slip it in somewhere in here and strap it down, and it would be fine. You wouldn't have to worry about it getting crunched. So everything that I have shot and used as bow material fits in here nicely. It's a big open case, and I'm not worried about being crunched. It's got the pillar lock system, as you can see here. It's got two sets of them. When you close the case, these two and these two will actually set on top of one another. So you could stand on this case and nothing would crunch the whatever you have inside. So as long as these are clear, nothing will be touched by the case closing. That's pretty much it. I hope you guys like this case review. I give this case out of a 10, probably a 9, because it does have some nice qualities to it, like the hinges and the high density foam and all the latches and straps you can strap your equipment down into, and the variety of different arrows you can place in the arrow rack. That's all awesome. If they could have maybe just a little bit more space for this sight to sit in there and allow the case still to close, that'd be even better, and that would push it above a 10. So other than that, everything is very nice with this case. I definitely recommend it. $100, I got it at Sportsman's Warehouse. I don't think you can go wrong with this case. It's all weather, and I don't think you couldn't go wrong with this case at all. I think it's probably one of the best hard cases out there for a compound bow. So thanks guys for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks guys.